The revelation late yesterday afternoon that Russian President Vladimir Putin had called President Obama raised hopes that the crisis in Ukraine might be resolved through diplomacy. But that's hardly a sure thing. Tens of thousands of Russian soldiers have deployed near the border with Ukraine, and they show no sign of pulling back. For more about that, we're joined now from Washington by Anthony Cordesman from the Center for Strategic and International Studies. So there are some estimates by Ukrainians that there might be up to 85,000 Russian troops along the border. Whatever the number is, do we know about the composition of those forces, and what can Russia do with that kind of an army?
Well, first, we don't really know the exact structure of that. We have been told on background that there are between 40 and 50,000 at least troops. They haven't identified which units they belong to. But Russia announced there were going to be exercises, and there haven't been any exercises. They've just kept building up a presence, one that could directly go in to the eastern Ukraine. The other problem is that troops aren't the only problem. There are very large numbers of Ministry of Interior units that Russia also has. These are almost ideal troops for occupying cities in urban areas. There are certainly pro-Russian elements in some of the cities in the eastern Ukraine. So at almost any time, you could have a Russian thrust into the eastern Ukraine, and one that could at least take some cities, probably in a matter of days, if not hours.
We've been focused so much on Crimea. Are there other regions that we need to be concerned about? Last week we mentioned Transnistria, which is a small region on the border between Moldova and Ukraine.
Russia has a limited presence already in the area. It's not a major combat presence, but there is no major combat presence in that area, in Moldavia, which is the nation to the west, or in the Ukraine to the east. So it certainly is an area where Russia could suddenly put pressure on the Ukraine. And there is an airborne guards division, basically, which could be moved in, at least in part, fairly quickly, because the Ukraine, frankly, is not capable of effective air defense. So Russia certainly has the ability to put pressure on the Ukraine in two different directions. And I think what's of great concern to the Ukraine is when Putin called Obama, he didn't talk about negotiations alone. He talked about the fact that Russia had no intention of invading if the Ukraine did not have hardline elements in its government, if there were no protests against the Russians. So it really was not, in any sense, a quick initiative towards peace.
So countries like Estonia, Lithuania, Latvia, they've been asking for increased NATO presence. Do they have reason to be scared and concerned?
I think, really, we have not seen any element of Russian mobilization or deployment, but these small Baltic states are near major Russian forces. They don't really have to do anything. They're already there to put pressure on them. And we have moved U.S. aircraft into one of those states, as we have into Poland. But I think certainly in today's climate, the problem is if the Ukraine becomes a major source of confrontation between East and West, if Russia goes beyond the Crimea and thrusts into the Ukraine, then NATO's response would have to be largely in other areas, and that could trigger a process of confrontation that none of these states can predict.
All right, Anthony Cordesman from the Center for Strategic and International Studies joining us from Washington. Thanks so much.
Thank you.